according to the Wall Street Journal today, will eliminate any effort for new drilling.
Well, it's actually designed to do just the opposite, Rush. First of all, our bill has nothing to do with whether or not the moratorium remains on after September 30. That's going to be an up or down vote on either a continuing resolution or some sort of omnibus bill. That's where it'll be included. I intend to vote to lift the moratorium. I think all five of us will do that. I'm sure all five of us will. This doesn't have anything to do with that. What it does have to do with is we've got a commitment for the first time that I can remember in my now 14 years in Senate, a significant number, although five may not sound significant, but it really is. We got five Democrats who are willing to say, look, you know, we think we need to be reasonable. In the last 28 years, and sure, we had to make some compromises on the other side, but what we've got is this. We've got common ground. Is ANWR common ground? Absolutely not. I voted down that, Rush, as you well know. I got elected to the House in 94.
I know, but this bill puts ANWR off limits.
No, it doesn't address ANWR one way or the other, but we knew, Rush, that we had never been able to get 60 votes, and we will not get 60 votes on ANWR in any piece of legislation right now until we get enough like-minded folks in there. But this bill says that while we know we can't do that, we can drill offshore. We're going to open up additional areas. Plus,
in four states.
Four states will have. But look, the Gulf of Mexico is where the oil is, and that's where we're going to start with in this bill. We're going to protect the beaches of Florida. That's why the 50-mile barrier is there.
The 50-mile barrier. See, the thing that has people upset about this is that everybody's assumed that the Democrats are going to sweep to major victories in the House and Senate and a landslide in the White House. This drilling issue came along with a tipping point of $4 a gallon gas. Finally, Senator McCain had an issue the Republicans could embarrass Obama with and perhaps ride to victory, because the vast majority of the American people want to do the opposite of what the Democrats do. So nobody can figure out why compromise with the Democrats and cut the knees off of Senator McCain.
Well, it doesn't cut Senator McCain's knees off. It really complements his position. But what it does do is it provides an opportunity to send a message to the markets that, wow, the president's serious about lifting this moratorium, and now we've got 10 members of Congress who have come together in a bipartisan way who say, also, we're going to lift the moratorium. We're going to allow more drilling. Look what's happened to the market since we started this conversation. Just in the last week, since our legislation was announced, our draft discussion was announced, we've seen a further reduction, Rush, in the price of a barrel of oil. Now, we're not taking credit for that, but the fact is the markets understand that finally Congress is not at loggerheads. Congress is serious about expanding offshore drilling. They do want to drill now, and they want to drill in places where we know there's oil.
But
plus,
Senator, the Democrats don't want to drill, and the obstacles to drilling that are apparently in this bill are going to make it impossible to succeed. I mean, letting the ACLU and groups, animal rights groups and so forth, have a regulatory role or at least a right to protest here, which is just going to make the permit process extended over and over and over. I don't see the Democrats compromising anything here.
Well, they've agreed that we move into additional areas of the Gulf of Mexico. They've agreed that we go to places like Virginia, where the two senators there want to immediately take advantage of this. And we don't know where there's oil out there or not off the Atlantic coast. We think there is gas out there, and we will have the opportunity to have immediate access. But let me mention one other key point to what we agreed to, Rush. One argument we've heard is that if you start drilling now, it's going to be 10 years before you see any results of it. Well, in the Gulf of Mexico, where we, number one, know there's oil, know there's gas, there's something else out there that is key to immediate effect on the market, and that's the infrastructure. They've got the pipelines already existing in the Gulf of Mexico, and if a driller were successful out there in the short term, we could immediately see some impact in the supply. And as you and I well know, supply and demand is what is causing the price.
Absolutely.
To do what they've done.
Absolutely. And I know the 10 years thing is a bogus thing. That's just that the Democrats are trying to shut down. I mean, they've turned oil into a campaign issue demon. It is It is amazing. So you say you've got five Democrats. By the way, we're talking with Georgia Senator Saxby Chambliss. You say you had five Democrats that were willing to compromise with you, moving in our direction. It's the first time in 14 years. Why not make them come a little further?
Well, if we could have, I assure you we would have. We had some very heated discussions between our members, even though everybody was respectful and professional with each other, but we did try to move them. I would love to have Anwar in there. I would love to have oil shale in there, although the technology with the oil shale is not quite where we could take advantage of it right now. And I think this, Rush, I mean, when people see and understand that we can, with the technology we have today, drill in areas, even where we've drilled before, and from an environmentally sensitive standpoint, not interfere with the environment, I think it gives us the opportunity to open up Anwar. Otherwise, I'm afraid symbolically it's going to be extremely difficult ever to do that.
Well, to me, that whole environmentally friendly stuff's a straw dog because it's been environmentally friendly for decades. We haven't had spills from rigs. We haven't had leaks from rigs. The rigs and the oil facilities and pumping and drilling and so forth, we've had, you know, tanker spills and so forth, but the actual infrastructure to get the oil is clean as it can be. We're not destroying anything with this. And the politics of this is what has some people upset. You know, they see Republicans always compromising with Democrats to move things forward, and they want Democrats defeated, not compromised with.
Well, what my constituents tell me is that they don't like paying $4 a gallon for a gallon of gas, and upwards of that. And if Congress could just quit their partisan bickering and come together on this as well as some other issues, they would see relief. And I think they're right. We're not going to see any relief as long as we just stand on the floor and butt heads with each other.
If butting heads with them leads to them losing elections and you getting enough senators on your side of the aisle to have no worries about having to compromise, I mean, that's the gold standard. Yeah. But just, I know time is running short here, and I just want to get one thing clear.
Sure.
The Wall Street Journal today says that this deal is essentially what Harry Reid wants, that it guarantees no drilling because even though there's four states that can drill, states have to decide it. You've turned the decision over to the states. The 50-mile limit and the new regulations, the analysts of this bill on our side say this is going to result in no meaningful discoveries.
Well, if that's true, then they're telling you something entirely different from what our analysts are telling us. We did our homework on this. We did our research. And the folks that we talked to say there is additional oil and gas reserves in the Gulf of Mexico. It's there now. We know where it is. There have even been wells that have been shut down there. If they're within 50 miles, we wouldn't be reopening them. But if they're outside of that, potentially they could be. So we know there's oil and gas there. The question is, Rush, whether you want to have access to it or whether you want the issue out there from a political standpoint. And I know and understand that. I understand that we're winning on this issue. But at the end of the day, we have the opportunity not only to win on the issue, because it's pretty clear Democrats as a whole don't want to drill. Republicans do. But people know that the price at the gas pump is not going to come down until we do have the opportunity to drill. As long as we stay where we are today and keep the issue, we don't have the opportunity to drill. But if we do have a compromise on offshore drilling, we can drill within a short period of time.
Senator, thanks for calling. People, I'm sure, wanted to hear what you had to say about this, because we opened the program with it, and understand your office is being bombarded with calls, as are some of the other Republicans. So thanks for calling in and telling us your side of this.
Okay, Rush. Thanks, buddy.
You bet.